Well, thank you, Alan, and good afternoon, everyone. As you all know, good research usually begins with a good question. And, of course, we're here today, as Alan has already told you, because the American Academy and the Alfred P. Sloan Foundation ask a really good question. Not what does the public understand about science, but what do scientists understand about the public? Now, both questions are important because science is so pervasive in our society that the communications between science and the public, which has to go both ways, has to be vigorous and insightful. But the framing of those two questions really have quite different focus. The first question really focuses on science. And as Alan has said, it can lead in its failure mode to some ways of framing that question that are not particularly constructive, the so-called deficit model, the why aren't you more like me because if you were, you would think like I do. In its worst possible form, it turns into the Rodney Dangerfield model. I'm not getting any respect these days. On that point, incidentally, while public trust in science may not be as high as we like, some recent polling from Yale and George Mason and Stanford suggests that the mainstream news media, religious leaders, and even television weather reporters command considerably less trust than scientists. The second question, however, focuses on the civic debate. And it, too, doesn't always work really well. To describe the failure mode for that question, I remembered a study I read now many years ago, which studied the relationship between policymakers and policy analysts. And the conclusion of that study, to restate it using the language of science and the public, would go something like this. The public likes to ask science questions that it can't answer. But that's okay, because scientists like to provide the public answers it can't use. And I think that's the problem we want to try and have tried to attack in this study. Now, the American Academy attacked this problem by organizing meetings on four current and prospective topics that are at the intersection of science and the public interest. The four topics were the next generation of the Internet, which was chaired by David Clark of MIT, a leader in the development of the Internet, a workshop on public perception of nuclear waste repositories, which was chaired by Tom Isaacs of Stanford University and Lawrence Livermore Laboratory, a third workshop on the evolving uses of personal genetic information, which was chaired by David Altshuler of Harvard Medical School and the Broad Institute, and finally a fourth workshop, which I chaired, on focusing on alternative energy technologies. Now, these workshops were not just collections of scientists and technologists and engineers. Rather, they included a mix of former public officials, of leaders and experts from government, state and local governments, advocacy groups, social scientists, journalists, and even theologians. They were recorded and reviewed in some detail, and I think that the total record will prove to be very valuable to folks who want to work further on this subject in the future. But in order to summarize the results of this year and a half project, we have turned to Chris Mooney. Chris, as many of you know, is a science journalist. He's the author of three books, and other things that are listed on the slide up there, which he's already taken care of. In the past year, he's been a Knight Science Journalism Fellow at MIT, and this summer, he's a Templeton-Cambridge Fellow in Science and Religion. And we're delighted to have him. After Chris's presentation, we'll be happy to enter into a discussion with all of you. Chris?